Welcome to Tasty Bites this Saturday afternoon. I believe you can make great food with everyday ingredients, even if you're short on time and cost conscious. You just need to cook clever and get creative. And for today, it is the spinach roll. These spinach rolls are the exception. They look fancy, but you can make enough to feed your family for several days in less than an hour. And for that hour, almost 40 minutes is spent in the oven, so you can do something else. Our ingredients for today: tomatoes, onions, spinach, chili powder, sugar, salt, dough, lemon juice, beetroot, plain yogurt, turmeric powder, as well as black pepper. Over to the chef now, who takes us through how they make this simple but delicious dish.
Hi, welcome to Tasty Bite. My name is Bala Maga Rogers. I'm here with Chef Rami Salum of Urban by City Blue Hotel. And we are going to cook something tasty, I believe. And he's going to do for us a four-course meal.
Yes.
I'll give him an opportunity to introduce the dishes he's doing today. And I'll be helping him along the way as I ask a few things, an interactive show where I will learn something, and I hope you will learn something as well. Thank you.
Thank
Please,
you.
Welcome have a
in Urban Hotel. Today we are doing a four-set menu. First one, it will be a cold appetizer. It's got some kind of spinach or skooma rolled in puff pastry and cooked in the oven.
Sorry to interrupt you a bit. Are you following any particular cuisine, or you're mixing a few different cuisines?
It's African cuisine, but it's fusion.
Okay.
Yeah.
Please,
the third course will be fried tilapia, which is very popular in Kenya, Uganda, Tanzania.
Uganda as well.
Yeah, but we were going to do it a little bit twist, the way how we presented, how we were going to cook it. And then the fourth course will be sweet potato donuts.
Sweet potato donuts?
Yes.
Like sweet potato, like our sweet
like
potatoes.
Real sweet potato.
Not Irish
donuts.
Potatoes,
no,
but...
No. Sweet potato donuts.
Okay.
And you serve it with some... dust of sugar, dust of cinnamon, a little bit of honey and chocolate sauce.
Okay, so that's a dessert?
Yes.
Oh. Are we going to have a chance to test this food?
Yes, of course.
Oh.
Hopefully after we finish,
that
all of
good.
Us will be here and eating.
Thank you.
Thanks. So we can start?
Yeah, I think we can start with our first course.
So first course, first of all, we start with onion. Would you like to do?
Yeah, please.
Please, chop onion.
How do you want it chopped?
Fine,
eh? Okay.
Cool.
I know a few things about cooking myself.
And we have another chef now.
Is that good enough?
Excellent.
Do I do the whole onion?
Yeah.
Okay. This is a very easy technique. I know I sound like I've done this for a lifetime, but I've done some practice and perfected this.
Excellent.
There you
but
go.
Of course, if I'm doing now, I'm already halfway cooked.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll need to pick up with the speed.
Yeah.
So what would be the ideal knife for doing this? The chef's knife?
The chef's knife.
Okay. Can you use a cleaver for this?
Yes, you can. You can use any knife. But normally the easiest knife is the one that have more flat.
Okay.
Bigger knife.
Oh.
And now we have some olive oil.
Okay. Why does it have to be olive oil?
But make it like.
But for someone who does not have olive oil, can they substitute it with sunflower?
Normally olive oil is the best.
Oil would be the best. Okay. Are there any nutritional benefits for this, or it's just a preference for the flavor? And
Olive oil flavor, yeah.
Okay. Now, there's something I've heard that people talk about. Like, I've seen it when I'm doing shopping. Okay. You find
extra virgin olive oil.
Yes.
Then
olive oil that is significantly cheaper than the extra virgin olive oil. Yes. What's the difference between the extra virgin
extra
and the other?
It's the first time you squeeze your oil.
Okay.
The olives.
Okay.
It's the completely pure.
Okay.
The second one, normally they add another type of oil, and again, they squeeze the olives.
Okay. Extract it even more.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. And
okay,
do you use...
Okay. Then we add on
should I use a wooden? Don't you better with a wooden spoon, or you can just? It's better to just.
The easiest way.
Oh, okay. Looks
now
easy.
Just chop garlic.
Okay.
Garlic normally you don't put it at the beginning because garlic is very nice.
Yeah. Did you add anything to your garlic? I see it has a bit of... It's just that,
Just you want to give it a little bit longer, normally you add a little bit of oil.
Okay.
Then you add tomato.
Okay.
Okay, in the meantime, I'm going to put the spinach. You can use any kind of greens. Spinach, skumash, cabbage, anything you are comfortable with.
Okay. Skumawiki. Is that a Kenyan name, you think?
Yeah.
Oh. Does it have another name? Yes.
Kale.
Yeah, it's kale.
Yeah.
I thought kale was different from skumawiki.
No, no, no.
It's the same.
It's the English name for skumawiki.
Oh, okay. Kale. I've had lots of kale when I was doing some juicing program for dietary. Just blend it with fruits and then have that for a whole 10 days, like a mixture of such fruits and.
No, but that course is really difficult.
Yeah, it is. I did it successfully twice. And I actually lost a lot of weight.
Really?
Yes.
Cool.
Close to 10 kilos, I think, the second
now we add
second
our
time.
Spinach.
No. Pointing this.
If you want to, add spoon.
But you don't really need
not
it.
Really
if you're skilled enough, you don't need a spoon.
So now we season in the way how we feel.
Okay. That is salt.
Salt.
Okay. That's paprika?
Chili powder.
Chili powder.
Yes, red chili powder. And that's it. Now we saute it like for 2-3 minutes and we add a little bit of lemon juice. Okay, you saute it. In the meantime, I'll start working on the dough itself.
I'm worried, I don't think I'm mixing this.
Okay, the dough itself, it's puff pastry.
Okay.
It's normally 1 kg of flour, you add one spoon of salt. Sugar and yeast.
Equal amount of sugar to salt?
Sugar is 2 times of the salt.
Okay.
Then after you mix it,
so one part salt, 2 parts sugar?
Yes.
Okay.
After you mix it with milk, or up to you if you want with water. After you mix it.
But imagine milk will be better, more nutritious and.
Then when you measure dough, how much the weight of the dough, you add exactly half butter. You put it in the middle and start.
Okay.
I will show you how we're going to form it.
Okay. There's something I need to ask about butter, because I've seen people do this a lot of times. They substitute margarine with butter. What is your take on that?
Butter works more tasty, and especially when you cook it in the oven. You know, when you do a milfe or veetard or this kind of dough, you need that air pocket inside.
Okay.
Which makes it crispy and it can stay for longer as fresh.
Oh,
that's
okay.
The difference. So margarine will not give you that effect.
Oh, okay. So after kneading that dough, do you let it rest for some time?
Yeah.
Like how long do you recommend?
Almost
2 hours.
2 hours,
eh?
But you normally, you open the dough this way, then you start folding it.
Okay.
1, 2, 3.
I hope I'm not ruining this. Good, thank you.
And you decide to change your career.
I'm gravitating towards this. I've been inspired by your story. Oh, by the way, he's besides being a chef, Chef Rami is a multi-talented person with a history in gymnastics. He has how many belts? What belts do you have in black belts?
Yeah.
That's in what?
Taekwondo.
Taekwondo.
Yeah.
Wow.
Okay, So now it's enough. Then I do it.
Okay. So what does the lemon juice do in this case?
That juice with skooma or spinach.
Oh.
It really is like, you're supposed, when you're eating spinach, you're supposed to have lemon.
Okay, it enhances the flavor and gives it, and that zest, the, what's it called? The word zest, gives it that, would you call it tangy? That tangy?
Kind of, it's like,
gives it that buzz, in the taste
bud. Yeah, I call it sour.
So, chef, how long have you been a chef?
I can say like almost 20 years now.
Oh. Juicy, cheesy spinach and ricotta filling enclosed in buttery, flaky puff pastry. These spinach and ricotta rolls are great finger food for parties, snack food on the go, and popping into lunch boxes. Now we remind you of our ingredients for today: tomatoes, onions, spinach, chili powder, sugar, salt, dough, lemon juice, beetroot, plain yogurt, turmeric powder, and black pepper.